This
So in the
conference will
last
now
session
be
we
recorded.
have in the last session we have discussed about the list data structure. We have covered the summary of the list actually. Okay, so list is a predefined or built-in class, right? So we can create an empty list object, or we can create list of it using group of or sequence of elements, okay, however you want, using the constructor, list class constructor. Okay, list is a predefined built-in class, okay, that helps or used to store the sequence of elements. So we list object can be represented using this operator. What is that? Bracket. We can store all the elements of same type. Also we can store the elements of different types. So this is heterogeneous. Okay. We can store also none value. We can add duplicate values. And list is okay. And you know, list is an ordered collection and it is not sorted by default. List can be modifiable once the list is created. That is what list is, mutable object. And list is index based data structure. You can access the elements of the list using indexes, right? Okay, so today let's look into functions of list. What are the different functions that we have in list? Okay, followed by tuple, set, dictionary. Okay, so list functions, if you see the list functions, let me take a basic list. What is this? This is empty list, right? Because we have used this bracket means, okay, it creates empty list, no doubt about that. What is of type? List type. And in this list type, you can look for different functions available in the list. Because it is a list type, you can see here multiple things: index, count, append, copy, remove, reverse, sort, extend, and set, clear. Okay, so these are the methods available in the list class, because list is a class. Okay, so let me start adding the elements. Okay, so to add the elements to the list, okay, to add the elements to the list, we have a function called append. So you can append the element. So I'm appending element 10. Now you print the list. Okay, you print the list. Okay, you print the list. So what do you have in the list? Just run it and see. So you will be having a single element, which is what 10. Okay, one second. Right, so it creates a single element 10 in the list. So append is the function that we have to add the elements to the list. Okay, what is the function? Append function. In the similar way, like, you can keep adding multiple things of different types. So let me append, okay, 20, or I can take a loop, okay, and I can keep adding the elements to the list, okay, for every element in the range of the things. Okay, I wanted to add 10 elements, or say 5 more elements. Okay, so here I would want to read the elements from the keyboard, element to append to add or append to the list. What I'm doing here, so I'm trying to read the data from the keyboard, and that I wanted to append to the list directly. And how many elements? 5 elements. Okay, so now after that, print the list. See here, now run it and see. So here, enter the element to add or append the list. Okay, I'm entering 30, so 40, 50, 60, 70. Yeah, 5 elements are over, right? So it's out of the loop, and finally it is printed all the elements. If you observe, so all the elements are within the quotes. That means that the input function returns the type as a string. Even though you enter a number, that is going to return as a string. So that is what because the input function, while it is given like you, it doesn't know like what user is going to enter, either integer number or floating point number, what number he is going to enter. So that is the reason here. So it takes all as a strings. Okay, so user can enter hello, user can enter 10.5, right? User can enter some complex type. So anything, user can enter anything. So that is the reason. So by default, the input function is going to consider that as a string, because within the string, everything can be, everything is possible to represent. So 1, hello, 10.5, 1 plus 2, z, 2, all the things. Right, guys? So if you want to convert them into a particular type, yeah, you can convert if you want. So if you are sure that you are going to enter the integer, then you convert this input value into integer and append to the list. Okay, guys, is that clear how to add elements to a list? Okay, so add or append. So you are good with this, right? You are good with this. The next thing, let's play with this. Append, we have append. We have something called count. So what does it mean? Count is going to return, okay, count returns the number of occurrences of the given element in the list. Is that understandable, guys? Whatever I'm typing here. Okay, so count returns the number of occurrences of the given element in the list. So how many times I have 10 in my list, how many times I have 20 in my list, so that occurrences it is going to return. So let me append 10 again here. So how many times I have 10 in my list, guys, that number it is going to return, number. Okay, so if you want to see, just print the number of times it occurs. Okay, number of times. Okay, that number occurred. Okay, number of times the number occurred in the list is this. Okay, so this is number of times. So here the number is what, 10. I am looking for 10. Okay, so the first place, so here I'm going to give 10, right? Count of 10, and here I'm going to give number. So number of times the element 10 occurred, okay, in the list is these many times. See that? Okay, so 20, 30, 40, 50. Now see that how many times it is occurred. Number of times it is occurred in the list is 2. Why it is coming like this? I want to format it, actually, not comma. I wanted to format it. Okay. Observe this, guys. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. See that. So number of times the element 10 occurred in the list is what? 2 times. Okay, occurred in the list is 2 times. But if you look at 10, how many times are there? So here I have 10, and here I have. So after adding that, I did not print the list, right? So that is where. So let me print this. Okay, again here. Please observe. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay, that's it. So after appending the 10 here, you can see the value here. Okay, so how many times total 10s are there? By looking at, so here 110, here one more 10, but here one more 10. Total 3 10s we can see here, right? 3 10s. But how many it is given? So only 2. What is the reason? That is what, because it is going to look for the integers. The type matters here. So So the 10 is, it is not integer here, it is string type, so it is not going to consider that. Only two integers it is going to list, because you are looking for integer 10. Okay, that's what the element. If you give like this the element, now it is going to return only one, because you have only one value string of 10. Okay, so that matters, the type matters when you are giving it. All right, so count function is going to return the number of occurrences of element in the given list. So you have something called index. Okay, so index function is a kind of search function, guys. Index function is going to give the index, it returns the index, returns the index position, index position of the given string. Okay, so return the index position of the given element. Okay, given element of the given element in the list. So index is a kind of search functionality. Okay, it is going to search for that. Okay, so if you look at index function, what are the parameters it has? Index self comma object comma start comma end position. So here you are going to object in the sense element. So your element, you are going to give the element here, and self is nothing but the same list object. And start position and end position means if you wanted to search only within the particular subset, basically. I have 100 elements in my list, but I wanted to search this element in between 50 to 100. In that case, you can give that. Anyhow, those are optional. Directly, you can give the element here. So I'm giving the element 20. So for example, I'm giving the element 20. So now I can print this, right? Directly. Okay, index value of 20 in the given list is this one, l dot index of 20. Okay, so this is going to give the one, two, three, four, five. So here 20. So where I have 20 here, right? What is the index position of 20, guys? So this is 0, this is 0th position, this is first position, right? This is second position. Index starts from 0. So where the 20 is located in the list, it is located in the first position, first indexed position, right? Second position, but first indexed position it is. Okay, index value is 1. So that is what you can see. Index value of 20 in the given list is what? 1. Okay, so it is going to return the first occurrences of the given element from the list. Say first, when I say first occurrence, for example, I have given 10 instead of 20. Then here I have 10 value at 0th position. Also, I have 10 value at last index, right? In that case, it returns this index value. That's what first occurrence, index position. First, whenever it matches, whenever it finds the first, it is going to return that. Okay, so the point here, returns the index position of the given element in the list, returns the first occurrence, first index position. Okay, first occurrence, index position of the given element in the list. Hope you understand that. The similar way, you have count, we have seen append, we have seen index, you can copy it. What it is going to do, it is going to create a like a copy, like a Xerox copy. Okay, it's going to give you one more copy. So let me say L1 is equal to L dot copy. Now print L1 is equal to L to just to know both are same or different. Okay, to just know copied one original list is equivalent to or both original list and copied list same. Okay, so just I'm checking that. Okay guys, hope you're following. All these are just functions we have in the list class. We are just checking that. Are both original list and copied list are same? Yes, true returns means that both are same, because you copied that, you copied that. Okay, both are going to, like, you just created an alias, you just created an alias name, that's all. Okay, your original list will be there. So l is referring to this. When you say l dot copy, it is not going to create a new copy here. What it does, right, whatever new reference, so that will be pointing to the same list object. Okay, so l and l1 have the both have the same IDs. Okay, copy is going to just create an alias name to the same copy, that's it. It is not physically copying this or creating the same copy, one more copy and pointing to l1. No, this is wrong. Okay, so it just creates an alias name that points to the same collection, that points to the same object, right? Guys, hope it's clear for everyone. Right, now you can play with that, still count, append, you can remove. What remove is going to do? So if you want to delete some element from the collection, you wanted to delete something from the collection, okay, wanted to delete something from the collection, then you can use the remove function. What you wanted to remove? Okay, I wanted to remove 10 from my collection. So is it going to remove all the 10s? I have two 10s, right? So I have two 10s in my list, correct? Is it going to remove two, both the 10s that I have in my list? See that? So here I have printed after this. So is it removed 10? Yes, it is removed. So compare this one, compare this list and this list. Compare this. So this from this list, so it is removed a 10, right? Is it removed the first one or all the 10s? It is removed only the first 10. So that is what, it's a kind of index. So it is going to find the first occurrence of the element, given element, and removes the first occurrence of a given element in the list. Guys, following? Removes the first occurrence of the element, right? So that's what remove function. And we have something called pop function also. Okay, pop function, you know, this also removes it, but removes the last element. It's a kind of pop and push operations, you know, stack data structure, how it works. If you look at stack, right, so it's going to keep the elements in this way, so in the stack, in the rack, right, stack operation. So it keeps the elements like this. Okay, so say for example 10 I have here, maybe 1, 2, 3, something like this, the elements I have. Okay, now when I say pop function, right, it is going to remove the last element, top element from the stack. It will be removed. Okay, pop, it is going to pop the last element. Okay, that's what the pop function does. Okay, like a stack operation, pop function is going to remove the last element from the list. So after that, you just print the list. Okay, guys, just follow this. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here, see that the difference, earlier I have 10, after that pop, so the last element is removed or not? So it's just going to remove the last element. Pop is going to remove the last element. Remove is going to element the given element. So 10 you have given, it's not the index. Okay, so that is the note you have to consider, guys. Here 10 is the object but not the index. Okay, but not the index, you have to remember that. Okay, then I have something called l dot pop of index also. Suppose I wanted to remove the third element. Okay, then removes the element at the given index. Okay, meaning that, so here 3 is, so what is the note here? 3 is the index value but not next value, but not the, it's index value but not the object, right? You have to compare these two. So here it is what? Element, but here it is what? Index. Okay, now what is the element that I have at third index position? Oh, you just see the console in the earlier run and see that Here you see that. So here, this is what final list we have all after all operations. Okay, out of this, the third index position is what? So this is 0th index, this is first index, second index, and third index. So it is going to remove this particular element. Okay. Okay, anyhow, so let me give some different numbers instead of three. Maybe I'll give some different number. That's where you can identify the difference. Okay. It is not the element, but it is index position. The third is index position. So run this. Now I'm giving some different items here. Okay, maybe A, B, C, D, E. Okay, I'm giving the elements. Now see that the third position element is what? Just before removing that. So this is what my list, right? So this is 0th position, this is first position, a second position, and third position element is what, guys? C. C is my third position, and that is removed or not. So at the specified index, that is going to remove. Okay, pop function, it's an overloaded function. We call it as overloaded function. Pop off without parameter and with parameter. Right? So if you don't specify anything, so that by default, okay, it is going to consider the index value as the last value. Okay, that is what we understand already about the default arguments while learning the functions, right? If you see the pop function, so here the pop function, you can pass the arguments. If you don't pass anything, okay, so remove and return the item at the index. Default is what? Default is last one. If you don't send anything, the index position is the last position, is the index position. It is going to remove the last one. Okay, it is going to remove the last one. Hoping that everyone following it. Any questions so far? Good. All of you guys are good. No questions. Cool. Okay. Just we are playing with the functions, guys. Nothing great actually. Okay, so reverse, what it is going to do, it just reverse it, that's it, just reverse the list. Okay, print, is it going to apply or to the same copy, meaning that, so I have a list of elements here, say A, B, C, for example, three elements I have, A, B. So this is what my list, okay, and my L is following, L is referring to this. Now when I apply reverse function, so is it going to impact the same list? So here itself it is going to change, here it is going to change, meaning that it becomes CBC, something like this here itself, or is it going to create a new copy and original copy will remain same, meaning that, so we need to, if I print L again after this, is it still going to give me ABC or is it going to give CBA? That's what the question is here. So if it would have created a new copy and copied the reversed elements, and then, so you have to assign this to a new variable, maybe L2 or something. Okay, meaning that L dot reverse, L2 is equal to L dot reverse or something. Then if you print L, that will be different, and L2, that will be different. So the point here is, are you modifying the same collection, or the remove function is modifying the same collection, or it is creating a new one? That's what you have to know. Okay, so here let me give the elements like this. Now see that it's reverse dot not. So the elements, if you look at 20 A B D E. So if you see E D B A 20. So is it modifying the same list or not? If you want to see, just assign this into new variable and see that both L and L2 are same or not. L and L2 both are same or not. Meaning that it is going to modify to the same existing copy. It is not going to create a new one. It is not going to create a new one. Simply like, you know, okay, this is not the alias name, right? Okay, you are assigning it. When you are assigning into a new thing, okay, meaning that, okay, what I'm trying to say here, this one, right? Where is that? Okay, so what I'm trying to say here, okay, so you print L2 also, print L2 also, okay, print L2 also, okay. So try to observe, okay, so L dot reverse I'm doing. So meaning that the change, is it going to change the existing collection list? Yes, it is going to change that. And after changing, you are assigning to a new list. What is a new variable? That is what L2. Now here I compared L and L2 references. L and L2 references. Okay. So but it is returning false, meaning that L is different and L2 is different. Meaning that it created a new copy. It is created a new copy with in a different location. L is created, L is the original list, and L2 is you created one more variable. But here it is creating a new copy and pointing to that. And if you print L2, you would see the same data. If you print L also, you would see the same data, right? So see here, L is equal, L2 is equal to, okay, so see that, run it and see the output. Oh, okay, it is printing this one, L2 is printing none. Okay, that is what, meaning that this is not returning any value, guys. Just reverse in place, meaning that the same copy is going to modify, and this is not returning anything, so that is why the return type is none. Okay, so here you have to make a note of it, yes. Okay, you have to make a note of it. So none, it is returning none means what? It is returning none means what? The function doesn't have any return thing. This function is not going to return anything. So that is what, as this function is not returning anything, the value of L2 will be what? None. Because reverse function just reverse the given list in place. And it is not going to return anything. As it is not returning anything, the L2 value will be none. So none and L is a list, L2 is a none. Obviously, they are not the same. They are not same. They are going to return that as a false. So here, let us at the same time, let us understand one more point here. Okay. Let us understand one more point here. Okay. So here, not reverse function does not return what? Anything. So here return value will be none. Okay, return value will be none. So L2 value is what? None. Okay. Okay, let's understand one more thing here. Okay. So I have a list here, right? I have a list here. And when I say L.copy. So copy function is going to return a different thing, right? Say L3. Okay, L3. So it is not going to create a new copy, right? It just points, it just create alias name, and L3 will be pointing to what? The same copy L. So that's what we have seen already. So L is equal to L3. If I do, both will be having same ID. Understand? Pay attention here. And now what I'm doing, what I'm going to do here is, okay, I'm going to do L4 is equal to L. What is this? This is direct assignment, right? Guys, this is the direct assignment. So copy function, how copy function is going to work and how this equal function is going to work, are both are same or different? Now L4 is equal to L. So this is assignment, guys. You hope you are following. So this is what assignment. You are assigning the L to L4. You are assigning L to L4. And here what you are doing, you are comparing whether L4 and L both are equal or not. Okay, So as like as you did here. So here L3 is a copy of your copy of your original list. So here the direct assignment I am doing this. Okay, direct assignment I am doing this. So now just print. Okay, just print L, print L3, print L4. So I'm printing all the elements. I'm printing all the elements, right? So just run this and see the differences one by one. Okay. Okay, so print all these things. All these things are same or different? So here you can see here it is true and here it is true. So meaning what? The copy function and the assignment, simple assign function, doing the same thing or not? So this copy thing and this assignment thing both are equal. Copy thing and assignment thing both are equal. Both are equal. Hope you understand the differences. So here reverse function, when you do reverse, it is not going to return anything. So that is what L2 will be none. So L and L2 are different and it returns false. Guys, hope you are following. Okay, so assignment and okay, that's copy versus assignment, both works in the similar same way. Okay, what else we have? So you just apply sort. Okay, you apply sort function. Sort function is going to do what? It is simply sort the elements, nothing great, right? It's just going to arrange the elements in your order, arrange the elements in an order, that's it, right? So just you can see the elements are in order. Okay, so there is some error because of type error, less than not supported between instances of integer and string. Okay, this you have to ensure, guys, because so here I have element 10, but here I have strings, all these are strings. So to be, if you wanted to sort, okay, if you wanted to sort the elements, group of elements, the group of elements must be supported format. The group of element must be in supported format. Following? So here we have a combination of integer and integer and strings, so which are not supported. What I had to do? I had to ensure that I'm giving my list in a proper data. Okay, let me reassign the values. Okay, manually static, in a static way I'm giving some numbers here. Okay. In a static way, I'm giving some numbers here. All right. So now I wanted to sort this. Okay. I wanted to sort this. So after sorting, what is the output you are expecting, guys? What is our expected output here? So I have 3 is the smallest element. Then 5 is the next smallest element. Then 10 is the smallest element. 11. And then 14. 20 and 30, right? So this is thus after sort, this is what my expectation. So see that, is it going to do that or not? Anyhow, this doesn't matter for us now because I'm not using this list. Okay, so what happens here? It is printed none again. Why? Because what I'm printed? So again, the same thing. Okay, sort function is not going to return anything. So it simply returns what? It simply returns none. So what you have to do is after that you have to print L. Okay, you should not assign this to another further variable again. Okay, because all the operations to the list are going to apply in place. So you do not have to assign to any other variable. Okay. See that now you can see the output 3, 5, 10, 11, 14, 20, 30. So the sort function is going to sort the elements. Okay, sort the elements. So we have some other thing. If you want to sort in reverse order, okay. So we have something called a property of reversed, okay. Sort function reverse. Okay, what is the parameter here? Reverse. Okay, sort of reverse is equal, okay, reverse is equal true. By default it is false. Now you are doing a reverse true, meaning that earlier it is arranged in ascending order, right? Now it is going to arrange in descending order, meaning that the output will be in reverse order: 30, 20, 30, 20, 14, 11, 10, 5, 3. Hope you are understanding now. So it is going to print the elements in reverse order. Okay. So see here, the output is in reverse order. Right? Nice, right? Okay. Next thing, if you look at the next thing, so here, okay, the next thing here, list dot, we have some functions. Extend and insert. Okay, there are two more functions which are important functions: extend and insert, guys. So if you look at the extend, so you have to pay attention here. Okay, extend and insert, we are going to talk about these two functions. Okay, okay, how it is going to work? Basically, interview question: extend versus insert functions, how these functions are going to work. Okay, L dot extend. Okay, so now my L is what? This is what my latest, right? This is what my latest. Okay, to this I am going to extend another list. Okay, say for example L5 is equal, okay, ABC. Okay, L5 is equal to ABC. These are strings, right? Characters. So I have to keep them in quotes. Okay, L dot extend of what I'm doing is L5. What I'm doing now? So I'm going to extend my list. I'm going to extend my list with what? With this particular L5. Whatever the elements I have in L5, with those elements I'm going to extend. I'm going to extend my list. Okay. See, print this and see. Come on. Okay. See that. What is the output, guys? Can you? Anybody can guess here? What is the output? Any guesses? What is the output here? What is the output? What is the output? Any guesses? Not getting. Okay. So is okay. What is the L actually here? The L is 30 because L is modified here above, right? This is what my L. So L is 30, 20, 14, 11, 10, 5, 3. This is what my list. So this list is going to extend by this particular list. So extend in the sense, so is it going to get each element of L5 and appending to this? Something like this. Something like this it is going to do, or possible answers, or is it going to happen like this? Okay, so that's what you have to understand here. So the possible output either this or this, right? Because I'm just combining both the lists, L and L5, extending the L5, extending the L by L5. Right, so meaning that my list is going to, L is going to modify. I'm modifying my list L by what? By extending L5. My L5 values are ABC. So is it going to pick the value one by one? First it picks the value A and append to the list, then picks the value B and append to the list, pick the value C and append the list. Is it going to happen? Or so all item, the complete list is going to append as a single time and as a single element. Is it going to do like this, or is it going to do separately? So this is the possible things. You understand, guys? Now, so how the extend function is going to work here? Just have a look. Important. Just note this and we follow it. Okay. So how it is printed, friends? So this is what my actual list. And to the list, so is it extended element by element or not, or the whole list has a single element? How it is done? So it is extended by, it is extended by element by element, right? So it picks the first element and add it to this, picks the second element, add it to the list, picks the third element, add it to this. Understand what happens here? It is extending, it is something like this. Each element, it is appending. Okay, so for every element in L5, what it is doing is L dot append of, okay, element. This is what happens internally. This extend function, what extend function is doing, this is what it is doing for every element in an L5. It is taking and appending to the list. That's what. Is that clear now? So what is the output here? This is what the output. Okay, now I'm going to take another list. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Now L6. Now what I'm doing is L dot insert of. Okay, I am inserting L6. Okay, inserting L6. Now what is the output? If I print L, what is the output I'm going to get? So already, so my list is modified to this. Okay, my list is modified to this. After this, so it is going to insert this. So is it going to insert as it is? The list is going to just add, will be appending as a single element, or as extend, individual elements are going to add. Are you getting? Single element. Okay, it's going to add as a single element. That's what the difference you have to understand here. Okay, that's what the difference you have to understand here. Okay, so ABC, but we got an error, right? What is that error? So num, what is that? So here, what is the error, guys? What is the error here? Okay, L dot insert of, but simply giving error, but it doesn't say anything. Yeah, here type error. Okay, insert function takes exactly two argument, but you gave only one argument, meaning that so you have to give the index where you wanted to insert this element. That is what it is expecting. If you look at the signature of this function, because all these are predefined functions, right? You have to follow that. So insert the object before the index. So what is the index that you have to give your index value? You have to give your index value. That is compulsory here. That is not an optional. Okay, that is not an optional. So I wanted to insert my L6. Okay, I wanted to insert my L6 at the end of my list. Okay. At the end of my list is what? The length of, can I use length of my L? So length of L means what? It is going to return me number of elements that I have in my list. Okay. So here, if you want, you can print this length of L. Okay. Length of L is going to give me how many elements, number of elements in the list. Okay, so length is going to give us how many elements present in my list. Okay, so is it going to work? So let's see that. So see that now, list object cannot be interpreted as an integer. So now again, I got an error, type error. List object cannot be interpreted as an integer. Okay, I think I must be giving the reverse order. Okay, parameters are reverse. Okay, so insert functions, see the signature. Okay, insert of, first we need to give the index, then we have to give the object, but I did the reverse, right? That is why it's the error is. Okay, insert of, first I have to give the index, so length of sig, length of l is my index value, then I wanted to give that as 6. Okay, this is what the error. Hope you understand the error, guys. When you do mistakes, you will learn better. Okay, so this is what the original list. After that, so the L6 is appended as a single element or not. So it is going to add as a single element, individual element, whereas okay, the insert extend function is going to pick the each element and add it separately to the original list. But here it is going to add the complete list as a single element. That is what the difference between what insert function and extend function. Okay, insert function and extend function. Hope you guys followed and it's clear to everyone. Okay, perfect guys. Okay, perfect. Okay, so you can just you can try anything left out, guys. You can give it a try, but I think I have covered all the functions of list. Okay, so clear function is going to do what? It removes everything, right? Again, clear function is going to return none boss. Okay, just you apply it, then you print L6. Okay, run it and see. Now clear function is going to clear everything. That's all. So that's what it is going to print, what? Empty list, meaning what? Everything, all elements are removed, all elements are deleted. That's what clear function works. Okay, so yeah, as I told, I have covered all the functions of list, and I think nothing is left out. Okay, insert all the things. Okay, okay, so can we perform arithmetic operations on list? Arithmetic operations on lists, meaning that I have L and L1. Okay, can I do L plus L1, something like this? Okay, what will happen if I do? Is it going to give me error, or is it going to give me by combining both the list, or how it is going to perform? So see that, is, do we have any error around? No, we don't have any error. Then so what is the output it is going to give? So if you see this one, what is that L? Initially L is this, then empty bracket, then 20. So we see a different output. Okay, let's understand this clearly. So it's giving confusion, unnecessarily confusion. What I do is I'll take another list. Okay, L7 of 1, 2, 3, only that much. Now I'm going to take L8 is equal to, okay, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now L7 plus L8, I'm going to do it. Okay, no confusion. Okay, I'm just performing arithmetic operation plus on the given two lists. Okay, I'm performing arithmetic operations on the given two lists. So now see that. Okay, run it and see what is the output here. Anyhow, this is not our interest now. The last one is our interest. So what it is doing? 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, meaning that it is just acting as a union or not. So L7 plus L8 is going to act as combining the both the lists. Yes or no? Yes or no? So what it is doing? Just it is combining. Okay, it combines both the lists. Both the lists. So like a union. Okay, mathematical function union we have, right? So it's going to union. It's going to apply that union operation. In the similar way, can I perform multiplication, guys? L7 star L8. Okay, what I'm doing? Multiplication. I'm doing multiplication. So how it is going to work? See that, can't multiply a sequence by a non-integer of type list. You cannot multiply two list objects. You cannot multiply two list objects, but you can apply addition operation or not. You can apply addition operation, but this is not possible. This is not possible. Okay, this is not possible. This is not possible. This is not possible. Then, so you can you can also play with other operations. Okay, so let me say print of L7 multiplication in number. Okay, not another list. So I am trying to multiply with a integer value base. So is it work? Just we are playing with the operation. Nothing great actually. Hope everybody is following it. So what happens now? Is it going to multiply it actually? 1 into 2, 2 into 2, 3 into 2, something like that? No. So it is going to act as a repetition operator. It is going to act as a multiplication. It's going to act as a repetition operator. So if I see 3 here or 5 here, then what will happen? The L7 is going to repeat 5 times. Okay, it's going to repeat 5 times. If you see 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. So how many times? 5 times. Because I just applied this multiplication operator. So these are all like some utility operations that you can apply on requirement basis. Okay. So this is going to act as a repetition operator. Repetition. So this is going to work same way for strings as well. Repetition operator. We call it as repetition operator. Say, for example, I have a string of hello. Okay, on top of hello, I can say s.5. So what it is going to do, it is going to repeat hello for 5 times. Okay, we call it as a repetition operator. Okay, guys, you can apply you can try remaining arithmetic operations by yourself and you can make a note of it. Okay, so all this is about list case. So we understand completely in and out of list. Okay, list is a mutable object. It's a group of elements. It's a class basically, right? It allows duplicate elements. It allows none element. Okay. It allows, by default, it is a ordered collection, but not sorted collection. Right. Then that's where we have started with looking into all the functions of a list. Okay. So that's what we have covered as part of this list. Right. The next thing we'll talk about tuple and further set dictionary. Okay. Friends, so let's rejoin. Okay, I'm ending up the meeting. Okay, let's take a 5 minutes break and let's rejoin. Okay, for further 1 hour, I'll finish it up. Tuple set dictionary. Okay, meantime, just review this. Please review this now.